Chapter 5. The Champion Who Saved Grimoire.
Cornelia alone for a while, now that we've gotten rid of the soldier controlling them.
Once mirages are scattered and separated from their keeper, they revert to their wild state.
And wild mirages are something you just learn to get used to in Grimoire.
That's why you've got Mr. Warrior here.
Yes, indeed. However, we cannot rule out the possibility of another Bahamut attack. What we need is an alliance with another country. Some sort of mutual agreement to come to each other's defense.
Actually, word has been spreading of such an organization. An anti-federation group as large as a nation. Perhaps the time has come to formally introduce ourselves. They call themselves the League of S.
League of S. Do you know of any way to reach them?
The Thane of Saronia to the north has been in contact with them. I believe one of the merchants mentioned it.
Saronia, yes. They have been resisting Federation annexation.
Yes. Highness, allow me to journey there and learn what I can about the League of S.
Alone? To get to Saronia, you must pass through all manner of places teeming with dangerous mirages. And I...
Hey, maybe we could go instead.
Yeah. Mr. Warrior here, he and the brigade should stick around and keep the goblins in line.
That's right. Cornelia's legendary champion belongs right here in Cornelia. We're the best fit for this. We've got tons of mirages to collect, and could start just about anywhere. So, you know, it wouldn't be any trouble.
What a kind offer. You would really do that?
Sure. You're doing us a favor by pointing me and Lon in a new direction. We're glad to help.
I thank you. We are in your debt. Here, all Cornelian emissaries are given these letters as proof of their authority. It should help you on your way.
Thanks.
Well, there's no sense in hanging around. So long. Take care.
Bye-bye-bye-bye!
Your Highness. Okay, then let's get going to the Saronia place.
Just hop on the train and take that choo-choo the north.
Right, tickets, please. Go on, then. All aboard.
Holy amaze! I could stare for days at this place.
Looks like we're gonna have to find a way through.
If things get the dangerous or you need a break, don't forget the... Don't forget that you can use the gates to return to Ninewood Hills and take a time out. Alrighty, let's go.
Come on, bring it.
So bad.
go!
Yeah, we got this.
Whoa! How are we supposed to get past these vines?
What's this symbol?
That's one of Inna Crow's, the patented sizzle symbols!
She got it patented?
That's your cue to the Brain Alana Mirage that's learned the sizzle ability. And if you don't have a Mirage with the sizzle ability just yet, you're sure to find one close by, so keep looking.
I guess we're doing this.
Come on, bring it!
Thank you. ought to do
it. Oh, yeah!
Grimoire sure has no shortage of wonders, does it?
Okay, here we go!
I won't hold back! Hey, why don't you find out?
Go on, we're the waiting.
I'll pass.
What's that light?
Gotcha!
Now, go for it!
Thank you.
You won't know what hit you.
Ladies and dummies first. Victory!
Dude, it's on!
Let's make this good.
Come on! Watch!
predictable.
Rain, my legs are about to fall off.
Talking about it only makes it worse. But you do have a point. I guess.
Oh, wouldn't it be great if the mirages in our stacks could just carry us around?
Oh, come on. It's not that simple.
You can't...
No trouble at
good
all.
Good job. We can?
Dude, yes! Okay, here we go!
I won't hold back! That wasn't so bad.
It's so beautiful.
Wait a sec. I know I've seen that before. But where? I can't remember.
Giants traveling with a mirage? It seems clear. The two of you are not from Grimoire.
I totally forgot about hiding!
Yeah, we kind of forgot to shrink down too.
What's your name? You know, that staff.
My name is Yuna. Are you heralds? Have more of you been sent to plague us? Your kind have brought enough chaos into this world already.
Be gone now from Grimoire. You have no place here.
We should get the going while the getting's still good!
I don't understand it. Why is she so mad at us?
Yeah, Vaughn. What did you do to her anyway?
What did I do? Why is it my fault?
That all you got? You're mine!
Thank you.
Okay.
The way you use mirages. Only Luzfarna ever held such power over them. Tell me, who are you?
Huh? Luzfarna, you said? But that's our mother.
Hey, you're right. That was her name. Listen, you wouldn't happen to know this, Luzfarna.
Let me show you something.
The same one Mom used to wear.
What? Then it's her?
Right. I knew I recognized it. The ornament on Yuna's staff.
Roughly 100 years ago, a champion from another world saved Grimoire. Her name was Luzfarna.
Huh? Mom did that? But 100 years...
It doesn't make sense. Mom's a champion? And this is some kind of monument to her?
So, you keep saying that Lady Luce was your mother. Again, may I ask who you are?
Well,
No memory? That is strange.
Do you think you might be able to tell us a little more about Lady Luce? We'd appreciate anything at all.
I'm sorry. I only know the common legends. The ones Grimoire's people have grown up with.
Fine. We'll take anything.
Sometime around a century ago, the world of Grimoire was nearly destroyed by a being that has come to be known as the Demon Dyad. Luzfarna prevented this by creating the Ultima Gate, a bridge to salvation from which she summoned three heralds straight from the realm of the gods. Thus, she became Grimoire's champion.
That definitely sounds like something out of mythology.
Bridging the gap between worlds is a serious accomplishment. She must have been amazing.
That she was. But sadly, even though she managed to save the world from the Demon Dyad...
Huh?
The heralds, all three of them, chose to remain here in Grimoire. And one of them is now Brandalus, King of Bahamut.
Huh? But Bahamut? That's the Federation that attacked Cornelia.
Yes. After they finished saving the world, Brandalus and the others harnessed a legion of new mirages and slowly took control of Grimoire's lands, building a powerful federation.
A legion of new mirages? Lon, you don't think there's any connection to the ones we lost, do you?
What? That's not possible. We're talking about 100 years ago.
But where have we been? Nidewood Hills, which Enna Crow told us, was a world without time. Right, Tama?
Right there you are! Compared to other the worlds, the concept of time there is, let's say, more than a little bit the unusual. So, if you want to know just the how long you were there, there's really then no way to measure.
Dude, what?
If you don't mind my asking, whatever happened to Lady Luce after the heralds came?
Unfortunately, we don't know for sure.
Some say summoning the Heralds was an act that cost her her life, while others say she lives as a prisoner in the Herald's castle, her freedom lost forever.
Prisoner?
What? Well then, where can we find this castle?
I wish I could help, but I don't know where to find it. Not just me. No one. Not even the soldiers in their army. They say Brandalus keeps its whereabouts a secret.
Huh? How do you hide a big honking castle?
Hey, take it easy. Come on. It's a legend. Are you really gonna get all worked up over something carved on a rock? They share the same name. That doesn't automatically have to mean they're the same person.
Well, yeah, maybe not. But you can't try and tell me this is just a coincidence.
Would you listen? All the stuff we're remembering? Like Mom's name? What if it turns out none of it is true? But I guess there's no point in telling Lon that.
What is it already?
Oh, just forget it.
If it's Bahamut that you're after, you should start in one of the Federation's member states and do your asking around there. Saronia lies further north. I believe they just joined the Federation.
What?
Dude, what? But I thought Saronia was the place we're going to.
Then Princess Sarah must not have known.
Well, we've already made it this far.
Yeah. We wouldn't be very good emissaries if we turned back now. And we did promise to ask about the League of S.
I'm real sorry I raised my voice at you. I know you were trying to help us out, so thanks.
No, I should be sorry for attacking you. It was wrong to accuse you of being something you're clearly not.